Hey, Luke here. In this video, we're continuing our Getting Started with Ansible blog series. This one is over creating your first playbook. I'll put a link to the blog post down in the description of the video. So we're going to switch over to our lab environment. So in our lab environment, we have our Ansible control node, which is the server that you see here that we're connected to, which is SRV1. SRV2 and 3 are both Windows Server 2022 Standard Edition VMs. And then we also have two Red Hat Enterprise Linux servers. Those are RHEL1 and 2. So this is our host. Let's take a look at our host file. And in the blog post, you'll find a link to download the sample files. And as we release a new post, I'll be updating those that zip file with new files. So in our getting started directory, we've got our host.ini file defined, which is our inventory file. And you can see that we've got two groups defined: Windows servers and then Linux servers. And underneath those are our hosts. So SRV2, the IP address for that one, and then the same for SRV3. Our Linux servers, these are our two Red Hat Enterprise Linux servers. And then we defined our variables for each of those groups. These essentially are setting up the connections for our Windows servers. We're going to use WinRM. And then for Linux servers, we're going to use SSH. The first playbook we'll look at is the one we're going to use to install IIS, or Internet Information Services, on our Windows servers. And then also we're going to be copying over just a static HTML file along with the Ansible logo so that we can see that, hey, IIS is running, and hit that through a browser. So we first define the name of the play is install IIS web server. And then the hosts, well, these are the hosts that we're targeting, is the Windows servers group. So this is a dictionary variable. We're giving this attribute a name, just named it index, and then the root is the key, and then this is the value. Same here is the JPEG, and then the key is root, and then the value. We're defining a task. That task is to install Internet Information Services. We're going to use the Win feature module. And the feature that we're going to be installing is the web server. The state that we want that to be in is present. We can switch that to absent if we were removing IIS from the servers. And we're going to include subfeatures and the management tools. So you'll see that we're registering an event, which we'll use in our handler, which is next, to restart the servers if needed. So here is the handler: reboot when web server feature requires it. We're going to call the win_reboot module, and then only reboot if it's required. The next step is we're going to copy the content of the website, and that's where we're utilizing this variable that's defined at the top. So we're going to pass in the key value pair, item root. The first loop will copy over the index.html file, and then the next loop, it will actually copy over the JPEG. This is where we provide the with_items is where we provide the variable. We'll go over variables in a later post in more detail. So let's switch over to Playbook install nginx. This is what we're going to use to install the nginx web server on our two Linux servers. So again, you'll just see host is Linux servers, giving it a name, install nginx, web server, and then we've got our task defined. So the first step is to install nginx. We're going to use the built-in package module. Since we're dealing with Linux, there's a lot of built-in modules into Ansible. The name that we're going to install, the package name is nginx, and then we're going to just pull the latest version. Become true, we're going to go ahead and become sudo or root. The next step is to start nginx. We're going to call the built-in service module. The service that we're going to start is nginx. We're going to make sure the state is started. And then once we've done the install, started the service, we're going to copy over the config file and restart nginx again. That config file is here in this static site directory. So source, we're going to copy it over from this folder to the destination location, which is etc nginx, and then the file name. We're going to set permissions on that file. Owner is root, group root, and then the mode. Next, we're going to copy over the content of the website, just like we did for our Windows servers. We're going to copy over that static HTML file and the JPEG, but instead of looping over individual files, we're just going to copy over that folder, and then we're going to restart nginx. And then the last step is we need to allow HTTP traffic through the firewall. So we're going to add a firewall rule using this module, the firewall D. The service we're going to allow is HTTP, and then we're going to make sure that that's a permanent rule. We want it to immediately take effect, and the state should be enabled. This is the config file for nginx. It's just a very simple config file. So I'm going to go ahead and open up a terminal window, and we'll run these playbooks. You can run terminal directly here in Visual Studio Code. Just go up to terminal and click new terminal, but it may be a little hard for you to see on the video, so that's why I'm opening up a terminal window here. So I'll just change directory to the getting started directory. And the first command we'll run is to install nginx. So the command we're going to run is ansible-playbook-i. We're going to pass in our inventory file, which is host.ini. The user that we're going to use is Packer. And then we're going to ask for the password. And then this is the playbook name that we're going to be running. So as you can see, it's not, the web servers are not currently installed on our host. All right, let's go ahead and run this playbook. Asking for a password. All right, so we can see, let's take a look at the results. Gathering facts, task, we're ensuring nginx is at the latest version. We can see that both servers were changed. Start nginx, copy the nginx config file and restart nginx. Copy the content, restart, and then allow it through the firewall. So we can see that all steps were okay, equals 7. We don't see any failed steps. And then we actually made 6 changes. So now I'll go back to our browser and just refresh. And now we can see that we've got the static page up, welcome to Ansible, and then the JPEG. But the next step is we're going to install IIS on our Windows servers. So let's go grab that command. Again, we're calling Ansible Playbook, passing in the same inventory file, username admin. We're going to ask for the password, and then the playbook is playbook install IIS. Let's take a look at the results for our step again, gathering facts. And then we can see that on this task, install Internet Information Services, server 3 and 2 were both changed. Reboot skipping because the feature install did not require it. And then we can see that copying the content of the website, we copied the index.html file to both servers. And then we also copied the logo file to both servers. Play recap. We had 3 tasks that were successful, had 1 that was skipped, changed 2 servers, nothing failed, and we can see our skips here. So let's jump back into the browser and just make sure that those pages are live. Yep, now we've got the same page on our Windows servers that we did on our Linux servers. So that's just a quick run through of using some simple playbooks in Ansible to install web servers on both Linux and Windows servers. You can see the value in the playbook is if you've got a lot of servers that you want to apply the same configuration against, Ansible makes that a very easy operation. So stay tuned. We will be continuing the Getting Started with Ansible series. So there's a lot more detail in the blog post. If you want to check that out, I'll put the link down in the description. Thanks for watching.